On this episode of Andrew Bernard Outdoors, I get the monkey off my back for the 2021 deer season and kill my first ever deer with a fixed blade broadhead. So stay tuned and I hope you guys enjoy. Well, it's been a minute since I've been in the studio, but it feels really good to be back. I've just been super busy with work this year, and then I've been hunting all over the place. So far, I've been in Kentucky, Ohio. I was in Nebraska. It's been a crazy season, but unfortunately, I don't have much to show for it with all this hunting that I've been doing. If you guys have not been keeping up with the channel, I did release a little bit of hunting content from Kentucky, and then I went to Nebraska, and all three Nebraska episodes are uploaded. So if you guys haven't seen those, be sure to check them out. But as soon as we packed the truck and we got on the road to head home, the only thing I could think about on my way home from Nebraska was hunting here in Kentucky and Ohio. And as soon as we got home that following morning, we drove through the night, got home at like 8 or 9 a.m. the following morning. And the first thing I wanted to do was go check my cameras in Kentucky and Ohio. And then a few days later, I was already hunting. And surprisingly enough, I've done a lot of hunting this year in October. And that's not normal, because if you guys are familiar with chasing whitetails, there is a large portion of October known as the October lull. And this is when the bucks go nocturnal. They're not moving much. They focus on acorns. And you really don't see good activity from a mature buck during daylight unless there is a weather front, you know, bringing pressure and cooler temperatures. And surprisingly enough, we've had several weather fronts push through in the middle of October this year that brought really cool temperatures. And I've been spending a lot of time in the woods. But as October started to creep on and we were getting closer to late October, early November, I started getting in my head again about whether or not I could even get it done, because I've been hunting so much and I have nothing to show for it. And the last couple shots that I've made on deer have been marginal and they were not very good. So I ended up redesigning my arrow essentially right before we went out of town to Nebraska. I changed my broadhead and then I switched out my Nox. So I have this completely different arrow that I'm shooting now with a different FOC. The bow's paper tuned perfectly. There's nothing wrong with my setup now, and I've been shooting a bunch, and I wanted to get the monkey off my back before we got into the good portion of the season. And as luck would have it, as we're going through October, an opportunity presented itself with a nice mature doe. So here it is. What is going on, everyone? Today it is October 20th, and this afternoon I'm at the Hills property in my little staging area set overlooking that giant intersection on the northern portion of the Hills property. It's 3:40 p.m. and I just got settled into the stand about 15-20 minutes ago. Haven't seen a deer yet, but the hills has finally started to heat up here with camera activity, and I told myself
these past couple years I need to quit hunting based off of camera activity, and that's not been the case. I've been logging a lot of hours in the woods, and it's just going to continue as the rut starts to kick in here soon. So can't kill them from the house, but it's also nice to see that I finally got a few mature bucks running around here at the hills, and there's no telling what we could see tonight. Like I said, it's prefrontal conditions. You can feel the wind and the pressure switching. And like I said, it's supposed to rain through the night and into the morning, and then I may or may not try and come back out here tomorrow night and give it another go post-frontal conditions. So we shall see, but I don't know. I'm also kind of itching to get the monkey off my back. If we have a nice opportunity at a mature doe this evening, I will be letting an arrow fly, because I have yet to kill a deer, and I've already hunted three different states, so it's time to get the monkey off the back. It's time to get some blood on the ground and put a deer in the back of the truck and get fired up again about this season, because it's just getting started, even though we're already in October. But the good stuff's just getting started. So we've got quite a few bucks on camera right now, and it seems like every other day there's a large group of doe that come through this set. So we're gonna sit tight, see what happens. The wind's in my favor, hitting me right in the face and putting it towards the pond. So guys, stay tuned. We'll see what happens. It's 5:10, and I just hammered a doe. Literally smoked her right behind the shoulder. The arrow is coated in blood. I can see my arrow sticking in the ground right there. Not a single blow. Nothing ran off too dramatic or anything like that. It was quick, quiet. Monkey's off the back, baby. I know that deer is dead. I know that deer's dead. Literally have a white knock. I got rid of my lighted knocks. I'm shooting a white knock. That white knock, I can see it from up here. It is literally coated in blood, bubbly blood. Had 5 or 6 different deer pull up behind me from the food plot back here. 2 of them peeled off this way. 3 of them came straight up, and then the single doe came up right behind the mom and her 2 yearlings. So fresh meat for the freezer, baby. It's what it's all about right there. Oh yeah, she's toasted. She's toasted. Check out this arrow. All right, so just to give her some more time, and because I got a train that can kind of cover my sound, I'm gonna go down to the truck and drop my pack off, get my knife, take my harness off, and I'll come back up in a second. Also, just to kind of give her some more time, because I shot that doe at 5:03 and it's now 5:28, so hasn't been a full half hour yet. So I'm gonna give her some more time just to play it safe because of the mishaps that happened this year. But I'm pretty confident that she went down, and I couldn't have gotten any closer to those front shoulders than what I did. So if that shot didn't kill her, I don't know what will. I came back down here and watched the shot again. I'm feeling pretty good about the shot placement. And like I said, it sounded like I heard her go barreling down the hill. So I don't know, we'll see. We're gonna walk up here and see if we can find her, because like I said, it's been over a half hour now, and there's a processor pretty close to here that takes deer that takes deer till 7 o'clock. So I gotta find her, get her gutted, and get her to that processor before they close. She's going this way. Boom. She didn't go. She's right there. She didn't go. Shit, maybe 30 yards? She's piled up right here, son. Smoke City. All right. Redemption. Beginning of the season, I made a couple marginal shots on 2 deer and lost them, and that's a very sickening feeling. This was a quick, humane kill. Like I said, I shot that deer at 5:03, right behind the shoulders, and she didn't go 30, 40 yards from my stand. It's a good feeling. It's a good feeling. It's bittersweet, but same time, that's what it's all about. Went to started the season off with a poor start, and went to Nebraska, and then hunted Ohio, and it's just been a rough go around. Like I said, made a couple bad shots, haven't really had many opportunities at bucks, and it's just been a slow year and a rough year to start it off. But this is redemption, and it's about to get good here in late October, early November. So this is a good way to redeem myself and get her gutted and get her to the processor, go home, shower, and be back at it tomorrow, hopefully.